We are back over here at the Hilltop Oasis, as I have affectionately renamed this entire area because it's not so much a village. If it were a village, there would be something like houses, maybe? It's not really a village. But regardless, I'm absolutely in love with this area, and we're going to add another couple of things today. We are actually going to do some structure around our cow farm that we built in the previous episode. If you haven't seen that yet, go check it out. But we're going to do that a little bit later. Right now, we're going to hop on over here to this little spot that we've dug out, and we are going to build a nano farm, micro farm, teeny tiny, wibbly wobbly farm, whatever you want to call it. It's super, super cool and super, super simple. So let's get to it. We're going to go over here, and I believe we're going to place our farm. This seems like a good spot right here. So what we're going to do is we're going to dig out this block right here and this block right there. And then we're going to place a hopper. I think we're going to have it facing toward this direction, because this will give us the most options for potential direction for storage at a later point. So then, on top of that, we're going to go ahead and place a rail. And on that rail, we're going to box in a minecart with hopper. This is absolutely very important, because the very next thing that we're going to do is we're going to throw a piece of dirt onto the top of it. Well, maybe. Okay, well, we're going to put a piece of dirt there and then a piece of dirt there. The crouch trick is not working right now. It's actually opening up the hopper inventory. Kind of weird. So we've got our piece of dirt right here, and this is actually where we're going to grow our crops. And then we're going to come back behind here, and we're going to place a sticky piston facing into this block that we placed down right here. And this is where we are going to plant our crops in the micro farm. It's almost done. We are nearly done with this build, and it has not taken us very long at all. The next thing we need to do is grab some dispensers, and we need to grab this observer. We'll go ahead and place a dirt block right here and a dirt block right there, and then we'll go ahead and place down a dispenser and a dispenser, and then we're gonna take our third dispenser and we're gonna place it on top of that piston right there. So we've got a little triad here that's going to be shooting out bone meal at our crops. We'll get to that here in just a second. And then we want to put a temporary dirt block right here, and then we will have our observer facing into this dirt block, which one really cool tip that I have for you. I used to get confused by this all the time. Like, how do you know which way to place the observer? Because the face of the observer is going to detect or observe an action or an update that happens in front of it, and then it's going to shoot a redstone signal out the back from this little redstone dot. So how do you know which way to face it? I didn't figure this out until like a few months ago. The face of the observer faces the direction you place it. So I'm looking at this dirt block right now. If I place this right here, the face of the observer is facing that dirt block. So if we go on top of the dirt block, if we jump and we are facing that dirt block, it's going to face the observer in a downward orientation, which is exactly what we want. So if we break this dirt block right here, we can say, hello, smiley. And then this observer block will observe anything that's happening right here and send out a redstone signal. So we're gonna come on top of our observer here and we'll place down redstone dust, redstone dust, redstone dust in a little line that goes over to the side dispensers. But one thing we need to do differently about the back one, if we just place a redstone dust right here, not only is it going to power this dispenser, it's going to power by proximity this piston, which we don't want it to do because we want to be able to delay this piston from firing. So if we place a carrot down right here, this fires and it fires the piston at the same time. That's absolutely not what we want to happen. So in order to avoid that, we'll remove that redstone dust and we're going to place a block right here so that this redstone dust will connect up here, power that block, and by proximity it will power that dispenser, but it will leave this piston completely alone. So super cool little hot tip for you about how connectivity and things like that works with redstone. Now what we can do is we can take our water bucket, and thank you so much to Mr. Chips on my YouTube live stream gave me this tip. We're gonna go ahead and waterlog this piston. I completely completely forgot that you could do that, and it's going to spill a watery mess all over our grounds here. It's absolutely beautiful. We're going to leave it like this. No, we're not. We're going to go cover it up. So what we're going to do is we're going to block off here, we're going to block off back here, and we're going to block off right there so that the water is contained just to that piston. It won't spill out the front because we got the block blocking it right there. So then we can place a block down right here, and then we will go and drop a repeater just set to one tick for now. Then out of this repeater, we can go ahead and place a redstone dust here and a redstone dust here, and this redstone dust will power that block, and by proximity, once again, will power that piston, delayed from the original redstone signal because of the repeater, and it will fire forward our farmland block, which will break any crop that is growing on top of it. And because we put that minecart with hopper directly below this block, this will suck up that crop before it can go anywhere else. It's very, very fast. It will just go zoop right through there and down into our hopper below. So that's basically it. The farm is done. What we got to do now is I've got all of the bone meal that I have to my name. That's it. So I got an AFK right up there at my fish farm to get some more. We'll go ahead and drop an even amount of bone meal in all three of our dispensers. And this won't get us very far, but we will go ahead and show off how this thing works. We have one carrot right now. All right, we're going to place that one carrot right there. Did you see it? It's very fast. If we go down here, hey, look, we have two carrots. That's great. Then we can go ahead and do that again. We can do that again. And two carrots has now become eight carrots. This is fantastic. If we want to stand here, we can point our cursor at this little top part right here on top of the piston, and we can just go, let's plant, 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 continue planting. And if you want to avoid the like double firing of the piston there, just go ahead and throw that on two ticks. I believe that should do the trick. Nope, it didn't. We'll go ahead and throw it on three ticks. I think that is actually where it's supposed to be. We got 16 carrots now, and we can go boom. It's a little bit slower, which is fine, but it is steady. I can hold my mouse button down, or I can get an auto clicker, or if I've got an Xbox controller, I can get a rubber band and hold the trigger down, and we can automatically grow our crops. So we've run out again. We'll go down here, and now we've got 38 carrots, and this is absolutely fantastic. We'll go ahead and go through this again. We might blow through the rest of this bone meal here. Okay, there's our last carrot in our inventory, and what started out as one carrot is now nearly two stacks of carrots just by standing here for like 2 minutes. And we still have a decent amount of bone meal left. That's not bad. So, quick explanation of how this works. Now that we've got it all wired up, I do like to do explanations on redstone, so you don't just know how to build it, but why it works. So what's happening here is when we place the carrot down, which this farmland is saturated by the water that is waterlogged on the sticky piston. When you place a carrot down, this observer will say, hey, something just happened here. The observer will fire a pulse, which will power this redstone dust, which will go in all directions, and it will power the dispensers. The dispensers will quick rapid fire the bone meal to grow our crops. And by the time those crops are done growing, the three tick delay on the repeater will go ahead and push our sticky piston forward, which will break the crops and catch them in the minecart hopper below. Now, we're going to do the same thing we did over here at our cow farm. We're going to build a nice little water elevator to get them into a storage unit over here, but we also want to focus on a little bit of creative building today. So we're going to make this look really nice, and we're going to make that look really nice before the episode is through. So a few days have actually passed in real life between the last clip and now. Had a lot going on, streamed a couple times on YouTube, and right behind me you can see the mountain is coming together. We started smoothing this out a little bit. We got a little bit of a shaping thing going on here, trying to mask out the gold farm a little bit so it doesn't look like a giant hunk of square in the sky and looks a little bit more like it was carved into the side of a mountain. So we are well on our way to finishing up the mountainside. Just a quick progress update for you on the backside of the volcano mountain. Hamilton area as well. And there's a reason why I'm showing you this. This is all relatively smooth and unnatural looking. We're going to texture this up as well. We're going to fix up the cave entrance in the back. Not sure what we're going to do in regard to the inside of that. But the reason I'm showing you this is because Minecraft Live was this past weekend. And holy smokes, tons of things to talk about. But we're not going to talk about many of those things in this video. Because I do have a separate video where we reviewed pretty much everything that was announced. But the huge important thing is the next update, Caves and Cliffs Part 2, was officially announced to be within 1 to 2 months of release. And that means we gotta start cooking. I have a few more things I wanna do to this area, and I wanna make sure that it all looks nice and tropical and not so much this grass, but we need to get the moss all spread through this area. We need to clean that area up. We need to finish up the mountain. Oh, nope, I haven't forgotten about this room. There's plenty of work to do in here, too. We got creeper holes. We've got armor stands that have been blown up by creeper holes. We got all sorts of stuff to fix. A lot of this stuff is going to get taken care of over the course of live streams, but we may try to fill in some time here in between little segments in videos to work on some of these projects together. But we're not going to do any of that today. We're going to focus just on our little miniature crop farm and our cow farm and finishing up those designs as well so we can start thinking about prepping this area for the end of the season. Oh, yeah, we got the inside of the volcano, too. Yep. Tons of work to do. We're not going to do anything too crazy with this. We're going to basically keep it similar to the designs we have over here. This actually has a little bit more of a unique design, but still fits that same color palette. Let's just go ahead and throw a few blocks in and see what comes out. While we're kind of building this up, one thing I want to talk about with the wild update is what is officially the next update of Minecraft. I had a few thoughts about the wild update, and one thing that nobody is really talking about, at least not that I have heard, is why is it called the wild update? Now, we know they're going to do all sorts of biome changes, and they're going to do the deep dark and things like that. Ancient cities, the warden, some pretty cool things that I'm very, very excited about. But I still just kind of wonder, why did they choose the name the wild update? And I had some thoughts. I have to wonder, is that the naming scheme that they are hoping to go by going forward with Minecraft? So this area that we're in right here, this is called, currently, the Overworld. That's just what everybody knows it as. You go through our nether portal over here, and you're going to enter the nether. You're going to go through an end portal. You're going to enter the end. So, you know, why the naming scheme, the wild? Well, I kind of tend to think that they have named it the Wild Update because they want people to start calling the Overworld. It actually fits a lot better with the naming scheme of the entire game. They've got the Nether, the End, and the Wild. Overworld just kind of sounds generic. The Wild sounds a little bit more like this has a purpose. This is the place you're going to start the game. It's the wilderness. You're out in the wild. There's not been any kind of official announcement to say, hey, we're renaming the Overworld, but they have made it pretty clear that they don't really want to call the Nether the Underworld. It's not supposed to be like under the Overworld or the Wild, as I'm calling it now. They've been pretty clear about that. And so I think in order to get away from that naming scheme, I think changing the name of this realm or dimension or whatever you want to call it, I think changing the naming scheme to something like the Wild could be a really, really smart move. So, what do you guys think? Do you think that they are purposely trying to change the name of the Overworld to the Wild? And if so, is that something that you're going to use as the naming scheme going forward? I really kind of hope it is, because I absolutely love that idea. Again, that's something that not really anybody's talking about. I haven't heard anybody else mention that except for me. So, if you start hearing that kind of rumbling around the community, you heard it here first. So, we're still a pretty decent way off from the Wild update. We still have Caves and Cliffs Part 2 coming out before that's even going to betas or anything like that. So, we've got a little while. So let's talk about Caves and Cliffs Part 2 for just a second, because that is the most imminent update coming out towards the end of 2021. We are going to be resetting the Minecraft Bedrock Guide world with the launch of Caves and Cliffs Part 2. And I've been doing a lot of research. I've been doing a lot of looking online at concept art, just different ideas for themes that we could go with builds and bases for the next season. And one thing I am very, very excited about is continuing to stretch myself when it comes to my Minecraft building creativity. In the past, I have kind of kept myself within a creative box and built similarly to different things that I've done in the past. This season was one of the first seasons, honestly, that I've really stretched myself and broken the mold. I mean, we've got some pretty cool stuff going on up here, but like a pirate ship, never done that before. A custom volcano, never done that before. Like rebuilding a mountain, never done that before. Well, kind of did that one time, but it was made out of snow and it was much smaller. Never done a custom volcano, never done a custom cave on the inside. Just kind of like transforming an entire area, like redesigning an entire area like this to make it look completely different than it did before, because it all looked like this. This really mellow, toned down grass, as opposed to this really tropical looking mossy grass that we've put in. Like, this whole area has completely taken shape differently than when it started. We've got custom trees, different things like that. But if you look around this area, you don't see a whole lot of variety in the way of builds. This is probably the most unique thing, followed by the barn that we're about to put up over there. And then everything else is kind of within this similar block palette. And that was by design, because this is supposed to be the farming area. It's not really a village like we mentioned earlier in the episode. It kind of took shape into something like this, more than an actual village. And that's something I've never done before. I've never really built a village with structures that are unique in shape, form, color, etc., etc. It's all been like either underground bases or very, very similar builds. We're going to be doing something very different in the next season of the Bedrock Guide, and I've been doing, like I said, a lot of research. I've been trying to find some concept art for different ideas of build styles that I really like, and I think we've landed on something really cool. I'm not going to tell you about that today, because I do still want there to be some element of surprise going into, you know, season two of the Bedrock Guide, but just rest assured, we've got a very, very cool plan in mind for Caves and Cliffs Part 2, and it's going to stretch me farther than I've ever stretched myself before with building, creativity, all of that stuff, and I hope you guys are ready. It's going to be great. And there we go. There's the finished build. Again, nothing too crazy different from what we've already got, except for I added a little bit of a feature up top where we've got our carrots growing up on the top of the building. This doesn't necessarily have to be exclusively a carrot microfarm. You can put potatoes in here, beetroot. You could put seeds to grow wheat in there if you wanted to, but you know, we're not going to use it for that because we've already got a pretty decent amount of wheat in here from the AFK villager farm. But here's where we get into a little bit more unique building, and for this one, we're going to go ahead and roll some music, and we're going to do what we haven't done for a little while. We're going to go ahead and throw in a building time lapse. We've got our full farm complete, and it is a very good thing that we actually have this automatic wheat farm rolling, because these hay bales took quite a bit of wheat. It's an excessive amount, and we've even got some on the inside here, and we've got a couple of cows over here as well that are going to be serving as milk cows, not steak cows, because we're going to be fighting quite a few withers in the very near future on live streams. I just got a feeling it's going to happen. So we've got some milk to kind of counteract the wither After Effects and an easy access for that. We'll do a quick fly over here and check out the building from above. I absolutely love the basket weave look on the roof that we've got going on here. Just kind of a unique little texturing. And again, I love the deep slate tiles. We used them over there for the roof line. We used them here for the roof line. I think this is going to be the new shingles that we use for quite a few roofs in the years to come. But that's it, guys. This area is really coming together. Don't forget to like, subscribe, click the bell, and turn on notifications, and we'll see you next time.